Since 1989.
Your mom and I moved out here in 1989.
Changed a lot. I got here just before Playland, just after Playland closed. Then they went through a crack era right after they closed out Playland. The 80s came in. For some reason, they made that into welfare hotels and became a crack and hookers everywhere. Over the years, it became now what it is, which is gentrification.
Well, sir. Rides, great games, and fabulous food are also part of the fun. And parents, our 11 kiddie rides are open for your little ones. So pop on over to Rockaway's Playland and easy to reach Rockaway Beach.
Playland outside New York City. When it was first built, it was named the Atom Smasher. Alyssa, what was it like?
Well, it was a lot of fun. You're going up a big hill, and then you just get a big steep drop. And you don't know what's going to happen. There's all sorts of bumps and everything, and it's really exciting. It's lots of fun. It's great.
Did it make you scream?
Yeah!
This is Frankie Romanelli reporting for Kids Rel from Rockaway Playland, New York.
Playland was real cool. It was no Coney Island, because Coney Island was bigger. It was real nice. It was small. It wasn't so big. But, you know, when you're a little kid, things look bigger than ever. But it was real nice, and it was quiet. It was different than Coney Island, different style. More low-key family. At that point, Coney Island in the 70s and 80s was not for families. You still had the teenagers, but, again, they were different than everywhere else. You know, like rock, it's Rockaway, you know. It was just after the Ramones and all that Rockaway. So it had a little bit of everything. It had a lot of personality. We were from Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn. So we stomp our way through and be knuckleheads. And, you know, we left our mark. We, you know, soldiered right through. Yeah, I got jumped a few times. I have a few scars, you know. Things that you know, would have happened anyway in Brooklyn. We were out of our sorts, out of our place. There was no way we should have been here. Hopping a train all the way from Bed-Stuy to the Rockaways to go to Playland, it's a long ride.
The sun is out and I'm awesome. It's not a whole lot hard to reach. We get into ride to Rockaway Beach. I'm on the roof, I don't down in the playground, I'm going to first ride is too slow. A blast that let's go on the radio. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. We get into ride to Rockaway Beach. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. Rock, rock, Rockaway Beach. We get into ride to Rockaway Beach. Start holding up all to reach. We get into ride to Rockaway Beach.
How do you feel about its destruction?
I didn't like it. I didn't like it. Even though I got right after it happened, is when your mom and I moved into the bungalow there. I didn't like it. It was, you know, anytime something like that happens, it's like hollow, you know? It's almost like the wind blows a different way.
Rockaway is now a shadow of what it once was. What used to be a prime vacation spot filled with magnificent hotels turn into an empty ghost town, only showing its face during the summer. This small beach town went from creating its own income to relying on the masses of tourists who flock here each summer, most of whom bring trash to leave on the beach and street. With the recent rise of tourism and developmental projects thanks to the Hurricane Sandy Rebuilding Task Force, gentrification has come in full force, creating an awkward mix of projects on one side and rural housing on the other. It's a question of how the small local community that have grown up here can survive this massive wave of change, while also preserving Rockaway's authenticity, and overall, what makes Rockaway.